It is time for Wildcats baseball. Let's go to Rockwall for today's game. It's called by KSST Sports Director Don Julian. Don?
James, thank you very much. They're introducing the Wildcats reserves right now. Let's join them.
Playing right field, number 8, Cameron Harrison. Playing center field, number 11, Austin Dodd. Playing left field, number 5, Jace Thompson. Playing third base, batting seventh, number 7, Will Sims. Pitching today is number 14, Payson Edwards. Behind the plate today will be Jace Birchfield, number 12. Deadline hitter number 2, Jake Davis.
On your left.
For the outs today, you have number 2, Riley Walter.
On your left.
Number 3, Gio Palmia. Number 4, Ryan Jenkins. Number 6, David Fowler. Number 10, Tony Smith. Number 12, Trevor Smith. Number 14, T.J. Brackle. Number 15, Aiden Lee. Number 16, Cam Brister. Number 19, Adam Carlson. Number 20, Caden Brister. And 24, Aiden Chapin. For the outside, their lineup will be number 8. Ethan Wood. Number 7, Matt Haley. Number 1, playing center field, Brett Gower. Number 11, playing left field, Blake Alexander. Number 5, playing shortstop, Andrew Bell. The agent today is number 23, Lane Snow. Pitching today will be number 22, Zach Peters. Playing right field, number 17, Landon Guest. Catcher number 13, Bryson Gilmore. And playing second base, number 9, Parker Poole. Would you please stand for the National Anthem?
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
and our national anthem. As umpire meeting, they actually did these introductions during the umpires meeting. I don't think I've ever seen that before, but they seem to be in a hurry to get that task over with. And as I said, they tried to start it earlier, but that may have just been a mic check. And Joshua Owls are the home team, and they're out in the field right now, and they're starting a junior, Zach Peters. Understand he has a brother that's a college pitcher, so has a pretty good pedigree. I ran into his daddy up in the press box before the game, and he was telling me some things. And so Zach Peters, the starting pitcher, the catcher for the Joshua Owls is Bryson Gilmore. They have Matt Haley. He was the starting pitcher on Thursday night. He's down at first base. Parker Poole is at second. Ethan Wood at third. And Andrew Bell at shortstop. Bell pitched in relief of Haley on Thursday night. Blake Alexander is out in left. Breck Galbraith is in center field. He was the starter and winner of last night's game for Joshua. And out in right field is Landon Guest. As far as the Wildcats are concerned, they scheduled hitters. Well, before I do that, we picked up the introductions late, and you did not hear the introduction of the reserves for the Wildcats. They are Cameron Zahn, Connor Bergen, Austin Kraus, and Jaden Janway. I think I said reserves, and then we had already missed those four guys, and so you actually heard the starting lineup for the Wildcats. Caden Argenbright will lead off for the Wildcats, Colson Hale, and then Jackson Chaney scheduled to hit here in the top of the first inning for the Wildcats in Game 3 of this area round series. And here's the left-hander Argenbright against Zach Peters, big, tall fellow on the mound, and first pitch is in there for a call strike. And first pitch is at 1:32. Yeah, I know we were supposed to be going by noon, but we announced on the coaches' show that the game would not start until 1, and it, with the rain and everything. Here's a swing and a miss on the next pitch, and Argenbright is in an 0-2 hole quickly to lead off the ball game for the Wildcats. And Peters, 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss. And that's out number one on the strikeout, and that'll bring up Colson Hale. As Joe Bob Bergen is in the house. Trying to figure out right now where he's going to sit. Here's Colson Hale, the second hitter in the lineup. Second baseman, and Peters' first pitch is swung on, hit out of play, foul off to the right side for strike one. So Peters starting the ball game, throwing strikes up there on the first four pitches. Now that was a ball bounced outside, and the count 1-1 to Hale.
Got this, coach.
And they're back on Hale at first and third, and very deep at shortstop out on the, looks like he's on that green artificial turf. Yep. High pitch, and the count goes to 2-1. Now to Colson Hale. Very quiet crowd so far in the early going here. You can hear a pin drop out here. And the 2-1 pitch is swung on and hit out to center field. The center fielder is over and makes the catch. That is Brett Galbraith. And that is out number two. So two up and two out, and that'll bring up Jackson Chaney. Chaney at first base. And hitting in the three spot for the Wildcats. And Jackson in the batter's box against Zach Peters. Peters winds, and the first pitch to Chaney misses for ball one. Maybe a tad outside. And Peters from the windup, and the 1-0 pitch, and that is up too high. 2-0 the count. And Chaney back in the batter's box. And Peters ready to go, and here's his 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss. 2-1 count to Jackson Chaney. If he can keep the inning going, Cameron Harrison is in the on-deck area. Good. And Peters now with a 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, and the count goes 2-2 on Jackson Chaney, who's really had a couple of cuts against this big right-hander. We play here in the top of the first inning. From Rockwall, here's the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. That was a breaking ball. That was a wicked-looking pitch. And Peters strikes out two in the first inning. Also had a fly ball to center field. So for the Wildcats, no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We've played half an inning here from Rockwall. The Wildcats at Sulphur Springs, 0. And Joshua coming to bat. Payson Edwards pitching for the Wildcats in this big game three of this area round series. Winner moving on in the playoffs, and the team that comes up short today will be hanging him up for the season. So Edwards pitching, catching is Jace Birchfield. Jackson Chaney down at first with Colson Hale at second, Will Sims at third, and Caden Argenbright at shortstop. Jace Thompson in left, Austin Dodd in center, and Cameron Harrison out in right field for the Wildcats. There's Birchfield's throw to second base, and ball thrown around and given back to Jackson Chaney, or excuse me, that would be Payson Edwards. Jackson was yesterday, Don. That was Payson Edwards, and they did the glove bump with Will Sims, and now Payson Edwards ready to face his first hitter. It'll be Ethan Wood, the third baseman for the Joshua Owls. Then Matt Haley, and Breck Galbraith. 1-2 and three, and before Wood hits, he's going to come down and talk to his head coach, David Shepard. And Shepard is now going over to the on-deck circle and talking to Matt Haley. Something about the home plate area. So here's Ethan Wood against Payson Edwards, and the first pitch is just a little too high for ball one to Ethan Wood, the third baseman for the Owls. And Edwards with the 1-0 pitch, and that was down too low, 2-0 the count. Wood steps out and looks in the direction of Coach Shepard, who's over all the way by the dugout. Here's a 2-0 pitch from Edwards, and that is in there for a call strike, 2-1 the count, to Ethan Wood, the leadoff third baseman for the Joshua Owls. And the next pitch is a called strike, and the count goes to 2-2 to Ethan Wood leading off. Will Sims is maybe in a step from third base, second and short, back deep, and so is Chaney at first. And Payson Edwards ready to work, and the 2-2 pitch breaking ball is swung on and fouled out of play. The count remains 2-2. Outfield pretty well straight away and maybe a little shallow for this third baseman. And Edwards now ready, and the 2-2 pitch. Call strike three on the outside part of the plate. So Payson Edwards starts with a strikeout, and that'll bring up Matt Haley. He was the starting pitcher again. A lefty hits from the right side, however. But Haley was the starter on Thursday. He is a Division I player that's ticketed for the University of New Mexico to play his college baseball. First pitch from Payson Edwards is swung on, hit foul, back out of play for strike one.
Go defense!
Oh, Haley hitting in the two spot, and Breck Galbraith is on deck in the on-deck circle. And Payson Edwards with the 0-1 pitch, a breaking ball in there for a call strike. Remember a wonderful game that Payson pitched last year in a big third game over against Wiley East. That game was played at McKinney Boyd. And the 0-2 pitch outside, ball one, 1-2 the count. It was a doubleheader that day. Ryan Humphreys won the first game. And then Wildcats came back and got the clincher There's a swing and a miss, and Payson Edwards is open with a pair of strikeouts. No, I've got my old book from last year. I could probably confirm that to make sure that I had all of that information correct. Have to back off a little bit to get back into last year. And the batter now is Galbraith. A breaking ball just off the plate for ball one to the three-hole hitter for the Joshua Owls. And here's the next pitch by Edwards. It's a call strike outside part of the plate. One ball and one strike to the center fielder for the Owls. Yeah, pitch is swung on and hit foul. Jackson Cheney coming over, but he'll run out of room over there. The ball out of play. Yeah, that found the Payson Edwards game. And the next pitch misses, two balls and two strikes. And Ryan did pitch that victory in, I believe that was game two. And a 2-2 pitch by Galbraith is sent out to right field to Cameron Harrison. He makes the catch, had it tracked out there. And the Owls go up and down in order. Three up and three down. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We played one inning now from Rockwall. And the Wildcats of Sulphur Springs 0 and Joshua 0. I was reviewing that Wiley East series from last year just to reacquaint myself with the way it went. And actually, Jackson Cheney and Edwards pitched in game one. That was a loss to Wiley East. Ryan Humphreys won game two, the first of that doubleheader over at McKinney Boyd. And then it was Edwards and Cheney with the combined no-hitter for the Wildcats to win game three. So Payson Edwards has a good history of pitching well with the chips on the line in game threes in the playoffs. And Cameron Harrison, the first hitter for the Wildcats here in the top of the second inning. Against Zach Peters, first pitch outside for ball one. Harrison hitting from the left side with open stance, and that ball bounced in. Count is 2-0 now. Peters had a strong first inning, and strikeout, a fly to center, and a strikeout. And here's the 2-0 pitch. Swung on and hit a foul around the home plate area. Two balls and one strike to Cameron Harrison. Out in right field, he recorded that third out there in the bottom of the first on that fly ball. And Cameron back in the batter's box and ready to go. And Peters with the 2-1 pitch, high and outside, 3-1 the count to Cameron Harrison. In on third base just a little bit and back at all the other infield positions for the Owls. Here's a 3-1 pitch, too high, and a base on balls for the Wildcats by Cameron Harrison. That'll bring up Austin Dodd with nobody out and a runner at first. Dodd, of course, out in center field. And another one of those, like we were talking about, Matt Haley, is a left-handed defensive player and a right-handed hitter. And now the third baseman really in, expecting the bunt. Harrison, a fair lead off first. First pitch high and outside, ball one, two, Austin Dodd. So Peters, a little streak of wildness here. After a pretty good first inning of throwing strikes. He's looking at Harrison at first. And the 1-0 pitch, Harrison running. It was a hit and run for the Wildcats, and Dodd fouled it back into the screen. So count one ball and one strike. Harrison taking off and Dodd hitting. As Coach Hammock trying to stir things up with a hit and run. Coach Jared Hammock down at third base, and Bruce Sillman down at first base for the Wildcats. Had a nice chat with Bruce prior to the game today. And the 1-1 pitch, Harrison taking off, throw to second will not be in time as Cameron Harrison steals the base. Dodd swung and missed it at home plate, so he's in a 1-2 hole. But Cameron Harrison steals second for the Wildcats. So a runner in scoring position for the Wildcats with nobody out here. And a good, dependable hitter during hot times for the Wildcats. They did lose last night to break that 8-game winning streak. But like I was telling some of the fans, another chance. It's not often in life you get a second chance, and this is one for the Wildcats after not a good ball game yesterday. Coach Hammock thought it may be one of their poorest games of the year. Dodd now steps out. The umpire called time. Harrison goes back to the bag, and the pitcher steps off. Talk about action and reaction. And Austin Dodd now against Zach Peters. Peters from the stretch looking back at Harrison. And the pitch to Dodd is swung on, hit off the end of the bat. Foul over to the on-deck area to Jace Thompson, who's getting ready to hit next. Count remains 1-2 to Austin Dodd. With 2 strikes, that third baseman has moved back a little. No longer anticipating Dodd to bunt. He has shown no sign of that. And another thing could be the runner's now at second instead of first. And the 1-2 pitch, call strike 3 on the outside part of the plate. That is the 3rd strikeout for Zach Peters. So 1 out in the inning with a runner at second. And here's Jace Thompson, left fielder for the Wildcats. And Jace Thompson in from the right side with Harrison taking a big lead off second. That shortstop's creeping from behind him, though. You got to watch him. And Peters from the stretch. And the first pitch to Thompson is down low. Oh, boy, Harrison got himself hung up, and now he's going to have to run to third. Here's the throw to third, and he's out at third base. So Harrison, the ball was in the, I almost said the dirt, but it was a low pitch that got away just a foot or so from the catcher, and Harrison kind of leaned off and maybe 5 or 10 feet off second base, and then felt like he was trapped, and the catcher threw to second. They threw to third for the out. So that's out number 2, and now Thompson hitting with a 1-0 count. And the 1-0 pitch, and that was down and outside too, so 2-0 the count. And a swing and a miss by Jace Thompson on the next pitch, and 2-1 is the count. 2 out, nobody on. Peters pitch, swing and a miss, and the count goes to 2-2. And Zach Peters with the 2-2 pitch. Swung on, hit foul off to the right side. And the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. 2 out now with nobody on for the Wildcats here in the top of the second inning. And Peters, 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss. And boy, Peters continues to mow the Wildcats down with the strikeouts. He's had 4 in the first 2 innings. So for the Wildcats, no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We've played an inning and a half now from Rockwall. The Wildcats 0 and Joshua 0. Bottom of the second inning here from Rockwall. And for the Joshua Owls, it'll be Blake Alexander, Andrew Bell, and Lane Snow scheduled to hit here in the bottom of the second inning. 0-0. And no scoreboard activity at all. We've had only 1 base runner who was on a walk, and Cameron Harrison was out on the base paths. So here's the cleanup hitter now for the Joshua Owls. This is Blake Alexander, the left fielder for the Joshua Owls. And Payson Edwards' first pitch is swung on and hit out into shallow left field. And the left fielder comes in to make the catch. Jace Thompson chasing Caden Argon right away from that one. And Caden giving way to allow Jace to make that catch for out number one. One pitch and one out for Payson Edwards. He's set down four Owls in a row. And that'll bring up the shortstop now, Andrew Bell, hitting in the five hole for Joshua. And Edwards' pitch is high and outside for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch on the way is swung on and grounded toward Colson Hale at second. He fields, throw to first in time to get Andrew Bell. And two up and two out for Payson Edwards here in the bottom of the second inning. And that'll bring up the designated hitter. This is Lane Snow. And he is hitting today for Zach Peters, the pitcher. So Snow, a right-handed hitter. He's in the sixth spot, so two out, nobody on here in the bottom of the second inning. Scoreless ball game. Payson Edwards' pitch is up too high for ball one to Lane Snow. Payson ready to work now, and the 1-0 pitch may have been a foul tip, but it was, if it was, it was caught by Birchfield, so that's 1-1 on the count to the designated hitter for the Owls. And a 1-1 pitch swung on and hit down the left field line, curving foul. You could see that from our vantage point here, that ball was really curving. It looked like it started out in fair territory, but hit about 10 feet foul down the left field line. The count, one ball and two strikes now on Snow. And he made me cold Thursday night because I had my lightest windbreaker on. Not a good move. Here's the 1-2 pitch, swung on, hit foul down the third base way. Just off the line at third base, and the count remains one ball and two strikes. Two out, nobody on, bottom of the second. 0-0 here at Rockwall, home of the Yellow Jackets. One ball and two strikes. That bounces in from Payson Edwards, and the count is 2-2. Landon Guest, the right fielder, is on deck for Joshua. And Edwards, the wind and the 2-2 pitch. And that was a foul tip back to the screen. The count remains two balls and two strikes. All artificial field here at Rockwall. We played here last year. We played Prosper on this field. And they are tough again this year, but they've moved up to 6A in the meantime. Here's a 2-2 pitch, breaking ball just off the plate. Fans wanted that one. 3-2 the count now to Lane Snow. And Payson Edwards back on that pitching rubber on top of that mound. And the 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss. And Payson picks up his third strikeout. So Payson Edwards sets the Owls up and down in order in this pitcher's duel through two innings. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We've played two complete innings from Rockwall. The Wildcats of Sulphur Springs 0 and the Joshua Owls 0. Top of the third inning, it'll be the bottom three in the Wildcats' order. They'll start with third baseman Will Sims, the pitcher Payson Edwards, and the designated hitter today, Jake Davis. 7-8-9 for the Wildcats. Both teams, no runs, no hits, no errors. Zach Peters releases his last warm-up pitch. Boy, a big, tall fella. I'd say he's got to be at least 6'2", 6'3". Maybe even 6'4".
Big Will
Of course, he really looks like a tall fellow on top of that big mound. Here's Will Sims now from the right side, right-handed hitter. Leading off here in the top of the third for the Wildcats. Third baseman back fairly deep for Sims. There's a ball bounced in by Peters for ball one. Peters has shown a few really wild pitches, but he's also shown the ability to work the strikeout as he has struck out four of the first six in the Wildcats' order. Now facing Will Sims. And Peters, 1-0 pitch. There's a call strike on the outside part of the plate. One ball and one strike to the Wildcats' third baseman. With Payson Edwards, the pitcher, in the on-deck circle. And the 1-1 pitch. That ball foul back into the screen. Sims down in the count. One ball and two strikes. And Coach Jared Hammock just now making his way to the third base batter's box. And Sims back in there. And Peters, 1-2 pitch, swung on and hit foul down the right side. And the count remains one ball and two strikes on Will Sims. Down below us, a couple of rows, a former Wildcat center fielder, Mason Buck. There's a ball swung on and hit foul off to the right side. Count remains one ball and two strikes. Fun time of year with a lot of the college kids making their way back to Sulphur Springs. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Just missed inside, and the count goes to 2-2. That was a close pitch on the breaking ball there for Peters. And the 2-2 pitch, high and outside. And the count goes full now to Will Sims at three balls and two strikes. And the 3-2 pitch on the way is swung on and hit deep to center field. The center fielder backing up, though, has it tracked and makes the catch out there. That was Brett Galbraith. And that is out number one. Well struck, but center fielder had plenty of time to run that one down, and that'll bring up pitcher Payson Edwards from the right side, right-handed hitter, against Zach Peters, who set the Wildcats up and seven down so far. Well, that's not entirely true. Like, he did have a walk in there. There's a call strike, first pitch to Edwards. That's right, he walked Cameron Harrison, but he was out on the base paths. And the next pitch swung by, missed by Payson Edwards, and he is in an 0-2 hole. We're having a hard time catching up to this big righty who throws awfully hard. And the 0-2 pitch, that misses outside, one ball and two strikes. Just a little off the plate for Payson Edwards. Payson back in the batter's box. And here's the 1-2 offering from Zach Peters. Swing and a miss, and that is the fifth strikeout for Zach Peters. Two up and two down for the Wildcats, and here's the left-handed hitting Jake Davis. He's a designated hitter today. He's batting for Wildcats catcher Jake Birchfield. Jake with those bright shoes. And a pitch is in there. Peters pouring that ball in there, throwing very hard right now and throwing a lot of strikes in this inning. And the 0-1 pitch in there for a call strike. Peters just rocking and firing right now. How's it going? And he's ahead in the count to Jake Davis, 0-2. And the 0-2 pitch. And swing and a miss. The sixth strikeout for Zach Peters through three innings. So he played two and a half here from Rockwall. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. So after two and a half, Wildcats at Sulphur Springs 0, and Joshua 0. And the bottom of the third inning for the Joshua Owls. They'll have 7, 8, and 9 in the order coming up. Landon Guest, the right fielder, then Bryson Gilmore, the catcher, and Parker Poole, the second baseman for the Joshua Owls. Here's Guest, right-handed hitter against Payson Edwards, who has put the Owls up and down in order in the first two innings. First pitch to Guest. He offered a bunt a little bit, but did not. Well, actually, he showed bunt, but did not offer, and the pitch was outside for ball one as Will Sims started coming in rapidly. And Payson Edwards winds, and the 1-0 pitch, and again showing the bunt, not offering, and a call strike on the outside part of the plate. One ball and one strike from Payson Edwards. And Payson from the windup, and the 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball broke outside. Two balls and one strike to Guest. And Guest ready, and the 2-1 pitch is swung on and popped high on the infield, and Will Sims is coming near the pitcher's mound and makes the catch just right on the back side of that mound for out number one. That had to increase the difficulty of that catch, having to involve that pitcher's mound and that uneven ground there, but Sims does a good job of staying with that ball for out number one. Here's the catcher now for the Owls, Bryson Gilmore against Payson Edwards. And Edwards' first pitch outside, ball one to Gilmore. The first game that we did in this series had a different catcher. And the 1-0 pitch, and that is over but low, and count goes 2-0 to Gilmore. The first game catcher, can't find him on the list here. Here's a ball swung on and a hit, foul ball down the right side. A close ball off that line there. Umpire signaling foul out of play. Well, that's got me puzzled now. I'm trying to remember who that first game catcher was. And here's a ball hit off of Payson Edwards' glove, fielded by Argan Bright. Throw to first is in time on a close play at first base. So we'll have to give Payson an assist on that. That was a 1-6-3 put out from Payson Edwards to shortstop Caden Argenbright, and he fired to first to Jackson Chaney just in time for out number two. And so two up and two out, and here's Parker Poole, a left-handed hitter, and he swings and hits the ball to right field. Back a couple of steps. Cameron Harrison makes the catch out in right field for out number three. And once again, Payson Edwards sets the Owls up and down in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We played three complete innings now from Rockwall, and we're moving along rapidly here. After three, the Wildcats of Sulphur Springs 0 and Joshua's Owls 0. It's the top of the fourth inning. I found the player I was looking for. I had to list some reserves up at the top of my scorebook because I just ran out of space. They've got quite a few reserves. That was Riley Waldrop, was the game one catcher in this series. And now, of course, they are using Bryson Gilmore. So change in catcher from one game one to game three. Top of the order for the Wildcats here in the top of the fourth inning, Caden Argenbright, Colson Hale, and Jackson Chaney scheduled a hit for the Wildcats here in the top of the fourth inning. Both teams, no runs, no hits, no errors. Pitchers rule so far in this one. Pitch to Caden Argenbright. That bounced in for ball one. Caden struck out in the first inning. He is 0-1. Ready to play college ball at Henderson State University. Here's a 1-0 pitch, and it's a wicked one-hopper, but fielded by first baseman Matt Haley for out number one. He stepped on the bag, so an unassisted put out at first base by Haley on a well-struck ball, but taken on one hop by the first baseman for out number one. That'll bring up Colson Hale. He hit a fly ball to center field in the first inning for an out, so he is 0 for 1. Hale hitting with one out and nobody on. Against big Zach Peters. Pitch is swung on and hit a fair ball down the third base line. The throw to first is in time to get Colson Hale at first. Nice play by the third baseman there, Ethan Wood, who caught the ball and then his momentum carried him a step or two into foul territory. He had to make that long throw across, but did it in time to get Colson Hale. So two up and two out, and here's Jackson Chaney. He struck out in the first, 0 for 1 for the Wildcats. As we play here in the top of the fourth inning, first pitch from Peters, that bounced in, but they say Chaney did not check his swing for strike one. Jackson was sure trying to on that ball that bounced in outside. And Zach Peters, the 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss, big cut by Chaney down in the count, 0-2. Jackson had kind of a pedestrian ball game on Thursday until it really mattered when the bases loaded. And then he hit a single into left field to drive in two. 0-2 pitch, swung on by Chaney, hit foul off to the right side. Yeah, you have to watch hitters like Jackson Chaney. Boy, they can explode on you at any time. And lots of power for Jackson. They're playing him very deep, especially in left field. That pitch is swung on and hit well to a left center field. The center fielder going back and will make the catch about 5 feet from the wall out there in pretty deep center field. That was Brett Galbraith going back to make that catch on a well-struck ball by Jackson Chaney. But on this probably heavy air day with a lot of water in the air, it's hard to carry. The Wildcats go up and down in order in the top of the fourth. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We've played 3.5 innings now from Rockwall. Wildcats of Sulphur Springs 0 and the Joshua Owls 0. And Payson Edwards now out to work his fourth inning in the ball game here in the bottom of the fourth. Nothing on the scoreboard but zeros. And leading off now for Joshua is the third baseman, their leadoff hitter, Ethan Wood. He struck out in the first, 0 for 1. Pitch from Payson Edwards is outside for ball one. Payson with three strikeouts in the ball game. He put them 9 up and 9 down. And the 1-0 pitch to Wood. A shot. Ooh, went right. Looked like it went right through the glove of Will Sims. Sims, and what do you do? You look at that glove like, what have you done to me? A hard shot to third base. And Ethan Wood is the first base runner now for the Owls. I know you probably didn't give a hoot about that. Sorry about that, James Terry. He is Mr. Pun, by the way. Wood, fair lead at first, draws the throw from Payson Edwards as Matt Haley's the hitter. He struck out in the first inning, 0 for 1. See if Joshua might be playing small ball with their number two hitter. He does bunt the ball, and it's a beauty. Fielded by Sims, third to throw. Managed to stay on the base. A nice play by Jackson Chaney. Stretching out about as far as he could to keep his foot on the bag and make the catch. And now David Shepard's going to come over and talk to that umpire at first base. But the umpire pointed at the bag and indicated that Chaney was on the bag and then came off the bag after he had made the catch. And so the umpire, both the heads nodding there. But they Shepard did get an appeal from the home plate umpire. Now, I have no idea how a home plate umpire could have seen that ball better than the umpire at first base. But they have asked for the appeal, and the home plate umpire and the first base umpire are talking it over. And the longer they talk, you think maybe they have a case. Safe at first base. The home plate umpire has overruled the first base umpire on that call. And now Coach Jared Hammock's coming up and probably making the point, hey, man, you were 2 feet away. And the home plate umpire, 90 feet away down there behind home plate, saw it better than you did? And the answer obviously was yes. So, runners at second and first now for Joshua. Oh, no, that was supposed to be a sack bunt. And now here's Breck Galbraith, who flied out to right field his first time up. He is 0-for-1. Owls on second and first with nobody out. Payson Edwards' pitch is in there for a call strike. Payson got a bear down now with these two on and nobody out. Well, I said without getting it out of the infield, that ball, when it whistled, looked like it went right through Will Sims' glove. That would definitely be a ball that was out in the outfield. Payson's 0-1 pitch, breaking ball, swung on, base hit to right field. This should score one. Cameron Harrison coming up, and he will throw the ball toward the plate. Cut off by Jackson Chaney and runner all the way around to third base. So after a pair of errors, a base hit for Galbraith scores the first run for the Owls. And that's what crippled the Wildcats last night was the defense. And once again, opening the door there. Owls at first and third with a run in, nobody out. And here's Blake Alexander. You know, Edwards took something off that pitch, too, and gave Galbraith a little bit more time to recognize the pitch and to hit that ball into right field. So here's the cleanup hitter, Blake Alexander. Here's a throw to first by Edwards, not in time. Runner gets back at first base. Well, runners at the corners with nobody out and a run in for Joshua. After a strange appeal, I think. And the 0-1 pitch is a called strike. 0-2 the count. Home plate umpire 90 feet away from the call makes the call, and that first base umpire who had made the call, who was looking right at it from maybe 5 feet away, and he's overruled. My home plate umpire must have really had a good look at it. Here's a ground ball to second base. It'll score a second run. Throw to second in time for the first. Double play for the Wildcats, but the second run does come in to score. Both of the errors are a score in the inning. But the Wildcats do turn the double play. Went from Colson Hale over to Argenbright and then to Jackson Chaney. So that empties the bases. A second run came in to score, and the Wildcats turned the double play. So a two-run inning for the Owls. And with two out, nobody on, here's Andrew Bell. He grounded to second his first time up. Breaking pitch outside for ball one. And Edwards with the 1-0 pitch. That bounces in, 2-0 the count. Boy, Jackson Chaney did looked like such a good job of keeping that foot on the bag, caught the ball, and then came off the bag, but overruled by the home plate umpire. Here's a 2-0 pitch. That's up too high, 3-0 the count. Well, now Payson having a hard time against this five-hole hitter, finding the strike zone. A 3-0 count. Payson has not had a walk in the ballgame. And the next pitch on the way, a ball four, a four-pitch walk to Andrew Bell. So another owl on the base paths, and that'll bring up the designated hitter, Lane Snow. He struck out in the second, 0-for-1 in the ballgame. The Owls, a couple of errors, a base hit scored a run, and then a double play brought in the second run. There will be no RBI on that. And Edwards from the stretch. And the pitch on the way is swung on and popped up. It'll be back out of play. Hope it doesn't rip a hole in our canopy here that is protecting us from the weather. They've got canopies over the entire seating area here. Very nice for the fans. And from the stretch now, Payson Edwards, the runner, takes off. Breaking ball. Here's the throw to second. Not in time. A stolen base. Fans thought that the runner had come off the base, but the second base umpire says he was safe at second. Maybe we could appeal to the home plate umpire and see what he saw. So a runner at second with two outs after the stolen base, and 0-2 the count to Lane Snow. Here's Edwards' pitch, swung on foul, bouncing back to the screen, back behind home plate, and the count remains 0-2. The Owls with a couple of unearned runs here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Break the scoreless tie. Boy, the scoreboard has scored a hit on one of those that I called an error. That one, I guess, that Will Sims, it looked like it went through his glove. But looked like a ball that should have been caught to me. Well, you know, you get six official scores, you can probably get six answers. Payson Edwards delivers the 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball outside. Two balls and two strikes to Lane Snow. With Andrew Bell running down at second base. Bell is the shortstop, and he also pitched on Thursday night. Came in relief of Matt Haley, the highly touted pitcher for Joshua. Edwards, 2-2 pitch. Swung on and grounded to Argan Bright at short. His throw to first is in time, and that'll do it for the Owls. But damage done in the bottom of the fourth inning. For the Owls, they scored two runs. They had one hit in the inning. Oh, that's right. I see that. They have not ruled on maybe that play at first base. I'm not sure. But anyway, there was a hit. So the scoreboard's right about that. But they only scored one error, and I had two. So for Joshua again, two runs, one hit, two Wildcat errors, and one runner left on base. So we played four complete innings now. We have a new score here from Rockwall. It's Joshua 2 and the Wildcats 0. Top of the fifth inning for the Wildcats, and here's Cameron Harrison leading off, the left-handed hitter against Zach Peters. Been very tough so far. And the first pitch to Cameron is inside. It looked like it hit off the catcher's gear and came squirting out of there all the way near the on-deck circle. So ball one to Cameron Harrison. He walked first time up. No official at bat. And Peters, 1-0 pitch. That's high and outside, so he's having a hard time throwing strikes to Cameron Harrison. He's only thrown him one in this his second at bat. It was a 4-1 walk, and now it's a 2-0 count. Peters real tough so far, no hits. That's a call strike, and so it's a 2-1 count now to Cameron Harrison. Harrison, Dodd, and Thompson scheduled a hit here in the top of the fifth inning. Peters pitch on the way, and that was inside, and Cameron Harrison was hit by the pitch. He was waiting for the umpire to send him to first base. And so Cameron Harrison is hit by the pitch. He's been the only base runner for the Wildcats today, a walk and then hit by the pitch. And that'll bring up Austin Dodd now with nobody out here in the top of the fifth inning. During their winning streak, the eight-game winning streak for the Wildcats, when they would fall behind like they did today, 2-0, they would immediately come back. So let's hope in that tradition that the Wildcats will do that today. Harrison takes a modest lead off of first base against Peters. And Austin Dodd in the batter's box. Peters the stretch, and then he'll throw to first. Harrison back in easily against the right-handed pitcher. And from the stretch, Here's the pitch home, and it calls strike on the outside part of the plate to Austin Dodd.
Thought that one was high.
Harrison off the base, a few steps off the first. And Peters, though, this is a soft toss. I tell you what, when you're used to throwing, it's hard sometimes just to lob the ball. That went in on one big hop. Of course, it was thrown so slowly over there, but it was a one-hopper over to first base. Harrison easily back. And Peters nodding and nodding, but never pitching. And then Austin Dodd grew tired of all that and stepped out, granted by the home plate umpire. Harrison again, a modest lead off of first. He's very fast on the bases. Oh, one pitch is swung on and foul back into the screen. The count 0-2 to Austin Dodd. Joshua 2, the Wildcat 0 as we play here in the top of the fifth inning. With a runner at first base, the hit batsman, Cameron Harrison. And the 0-2 pitch that bounced in. The catcher did a good job of blocking that one, Bryson Gilmore. And the count now to Dodd is one ball and two strikes. That's tough to block, that pitch that bounces. You may get a truer hop. Sometimes I hit that dirt and take a crazy sideways hop. Not so much on the artificial stuff. There's a throw to first. And Harrison again back in there. Again, a count to Dodd is one ball and two strikes. No outs as we play here in the top of the fifth. The Wildcats trying to get something going here. There's another throw to first. Harrison back. So Peters really paying attention to Cameron Harrison on first base. Cameron with good wheels. Here's a 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. And Dodd is down on strikes for the second time today. It's out number one, and that'll bring up Jace Thompson. He struck out in the second inning, and that's strikeout number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for Zach Peters. And Thompson in the batter's box. They're looking for a possible bunt. The third baseman in just a little bit on that green part of that artificial turf. Fair lead by Harrison off of first, and Peters' pitch on the way, call strike on the outside part of the plate. That umpire has liked that pitch today, so and has been pretty darn consistent about it, so you're going to have to swing at that one or take a strike. Peters looks over at first from the stretch, and the 0-1 pitch is swung on, foul ball down the third base way. And count now 0-2 on Jace Thompson, left fielder for the Wildcats. Will Sims is on deck for the Wildcats. Again, a short lead off of first by Harrison. And from the stretch, and Peters the 0-2 pitch, that's up too high, about head high, coming in there to Jace Thompson for ball one. One ball and two strikes. And Jace back in the batter's box. And Harrison off of first base, taking about a two-step. Now he extends it a little bit. And the 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. And yet another strikeout for Peters. And again, that is strikeout number 7. Two out with a runner at first, and here's Will Sims. He hit a well-struck fly ball to center field his first time up. It was caught by the center fielder out there, Breck and Galbraith. So Sims got a good piece of one, but just needs to find a gap. Again, Harrison leads off first. Here's the pitch to Sims. Swung on, base hit to right field for the Wildcats. The right fielder slipped and fell, but jumped right back up, and the Wildcats remain at first and second. But a solid base hit. So the first sign of that wet turf coming into play here is Landon Guest grabbed that pitch, that ball in one hop, and his feet just betrayed him on the artificial stuff. So Harrison at second, Will Sims at first. They represent the tying runs in the ball game. And here's Payson Edwards. He struck out in the third, 0-for-1. Hits now with two on and two out for the Wildcats here in the top of the fifth inning. They're not holding Sims on. He has a large lead at first base, and Harrison a big lead at second. And now Peter's kind of kicking around that pitching rubber like he would around the dirt. From the stretch. And the pitch to Edwards. Call strike on the outside part of the plate. Looked like the catcher dragged that one into the strike zone a little bit. So 0-1 the count to Payson Edwards. As Peters has the sign now from the stretch. And the 0-1 pitch on the way is swung on by Edwards. Hit foul. The first baseman coming over, and it'll be out of play. And the count 0-2 to Payson Edwards. Edwards trying to help his own cause out there as he is the pitcher today.
We can get you an Owls uniform.
And Payson now steps back into the batter's box. Again, Harrison at second. And Will Sims running at first for the Wildcats. And Sims with a giant lead since the Owls are playing back on defense rather than hold the runner on. And Peters, the 0-2 pitch. Called strike three on that outside part of the plate. That umpire has loved that call today, and he is calling it consistently. Even when the catcher drags it into the strike zone. He strikes, Peters strikes out the side. And that is eight strikeouts for the big right-hander for Joshua. For the Wildcats, no runs. They did get a base hit, and they had a hit batter, but they left two on. So no runs, one hit. No Joshua errors, and two runners left on base. And we have now played 4.5 innings here from Rockwall. It's Joshua 2 and the Wildcats 0. Well, with these pitchers going so well today, it's a rapidly moving ball game, just like an hour four or something like that at this point. And we're in the bottom of the fifth inning. Be the bottom three in the Owls order. It'll be Landon Guest, Bryson Gilmore, and Parker Poole scheduled to hit against Payson Edwards here in the bottom of the fifth with the Owls ahead 2-0. And Payson Edwards' first pitch, a breaking ball in there for a call strike to Guest. Guest hit a pop-up that Will Sims caught. Back in the third inning. And Payson Edwards with a 1-0 pitch. That was off the plate, and the count is 2-0 to Landon Guest. Edwards from the windup now, and the 2-0 pitch on the way. That ball swung on and hit foul back in the screen. Two balls and one strike to Landon Guest. Again, that right fielder that we talked about that slipped and fell out there in right field after he had caught the ball. But the Wildcats did not advance on that. Here's a 2-1 pitch, that breaking ball up too high. 3-1 the count now to the lead hitter for the Owls. Payson Edwards has had only one walk in the ball game. Struck out a couple. And the 3-1 pitch just off the plate. I had that as ball four, but now it's 3-1 count. Home plate umpire keeps that count. I don't know where I went awry on that. But it is a 3-1 count. And Payson Edwards, 3-1 pitch, and that's ball four. So Guest with a leadoff walk here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Former pitcher and baseball announcer Dizzy Dean. Oh, those base on balls.
That's the worst umpire I've ever seen in my life.
I bet he hated those. And sometime they come back to haunt. So runner at first, nobody out. Here's Bryson Gilmore, the catcher. He hit into a double play. No, he did not. He hit off of Payson Edwards' glove that went to the shortstop throw to first, so he is 0 for 1. A first pitch outside for ball one, and now Payson Edwards is having some control issues here in the inning. He's only thrown one strike and has issued a walk, and down to Gilmore, 1-0. Short lead off of first by Guest. Now he inches off a little bit more. And now he takes off running. Here's a throw, and he will get in there easily as he really got a great jump off first base and steals second base. Pitch, I did not see. It was a strike, one ball and one strike to Gilmore, the catcher. So the Owls with a runner in scoring position. They've stole a couple of bases today. Edwards looks back at second, 1-1 pitch, bunted on, bunted fouled on third base way. It's going to roll right to the feet of the head coach there, David Shepard. Coach Hammock familiar with him from his days as the head coach for several years at Pine Tree. One ball and two strikes now, the count to Gilmore, the catcher, with a runner at second and nobody out. Payson Edwards from the stretch looks back at second. And the 1-2 pitch is swung on and hit right at Cameron Harrison in right field. Makes the catch. The runner tags up. The throw is cut off and then thrown to third. Not in time. So Guest moves to third base on the fly ball to right field. So runner at third with one out, and that'll bring up the second baseman now. Parker Poole. He had a fly ball to right, now to Harrison. His last time up, so 0 for 1. And Poole looking at his coach, see if they may have something on, some kind of bunt squeeze or something, or whether he just lets him flail away here and try to hit another fly ball or a base hit. And here's Edwards' first pitch, and that's in there for a call strike to Parker Poole. An Owl at third base with one out. Wildcats infield is in, and they're shallow in the outfield to Poole, who has pretty good pop in that bat. And the 0-1 pitch, he couldn't hold his swing. He went around, and pitch was down low. I want to say in the dirt, but it's in that artificial surface that looks like dirt. At least it's the same color. 0-2, the count to Parker Poole, the runner at third and one out. And here's Edwards, 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss. The pitcher's best friend, the strikeout. And for Payson, that is strikeout number 4. And it's the second out in the inning, so the Wildcats defense can now go back up a little bit. And here's the leadoff hitter, Ethan Wood. He struck out in the first and was on an error in the fourth, and he scored the first run for the Owls. Edwards trying to wriggle off the hook here. First pitch to Wood is outside for ball one. That runner guessed at third base, coming way down the line like he was thinking about possibly stealing home, but I imagine as much as anything trying to detract distract Payson Edwards. There's a breaking ball. That's a beauty. That's in there for a call. And 1-1 is the count to Ethan Wood. He's the third baseman for the Owls of Joshua. And Edwards, 1-1 pitch. Oh, that missed somewhere inside. Pretty close pitch. I think Payson wanted that one. He kind of snapped his glove when the ball went back out there. Close pitch on the inside part of the plate. 2-1 the count to Ethan Wood. And Payson Edwards from the stretch. Here's a 2-1 pitch. Breaking ball swung on and hit to Jackson Chaney. He flagged it down and will step on first base. Made an acrobatic stop of that ball right on the line. and then won the race to the bag. And Payson Edwards pitches out of a jam with a runner on third base and with just one out and got out of the inning. So that's going to do it for Joshua. No runs, no hits. There were no Wildcat errors and one runner left on base. We've played five complete innings here from Rockwall. And our score, Joshua 2 and the Wildcats 0. Top of the sixth inning for the Wildcats, they'll have 9-1-2. They'll start out with Jake Davis and then go to the top of the order, Caden Argenbright and Colson Hale here in the top of the sixth. As the Owls lead 2-0, scoring a couple of unearned runs in the bottom of the fourth inning. Davis struck out in the third, so he is 0-for-1 in the ball game. And he will face this big right-hander, Zach Peters, who's been really tough. Has only allowed one hit today. And the pitch from Peters is in there. He pours a strike in there. Seems to throw very hard. He's a hard thrower. And 0-1 the count to Jake Davis, designated hitter. Here's the 0-1 pitch, swung on and lashed foul back into the screen off to the left side, and Davis in an 0-2 hole. And Jake from the left side right down on the end of that bat. Here's the 0-2 pitch, swung on, foul back into the screen. The count remains 0-2. Now Jake steps out. Argenbright was chasing down a foul ball and returns it to the umpire. And the catcher will deliver that ball to the pitcher in person. Just handed it right to him. And they're going to exchange balls. So 0-2 the count now to Jake Davis against Zach Peters. And the 0-2 pitch, called strike three on a breaking ball. And I think that's strikeout number 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And two in a row. So one up and one out, and here's Caden Argenbright. Struck out in the first, then hit a wicked ball down to the first baseman on one hop. But it was right at him, and so he is 0-for-2. And just when Peters was getting ready to go into the windup, Argenbright asked for and received permission to step out of the batter's box. So Peters now ready to go again. And the first pitch to Argy, a breaking ball is in there for a call strike. Argenbright has been on the varsity a long time for these Wildcats. I think he came up maybe as a sophomore. And there's a ball hit up the middle, base hit for Caden Argenbright, a one-out single. Just eluded the second baseman. Dive for Parker Poole tried to get to that ball, but Argenbright had hit it so hard it really gained momentum through the artificial stuff. And base hit number 2 for the Wildcats. And here's Colson Hale with Argenbright running down at first. Little bit of break in these storms. I hope we have enough of a break. This has been a rapid moving ball game, so we've given ourselves a chance. I understand there may be some other stuff on the way, but hopefully it's still out there somewhere. Here's Colson Hale. The pitch is swung on and hit off the fist, popped up on the infield, and second baseman Parker Poole will make the catch. And that is out number 2. Here's Jackson Chaney, represents the tying run for the Wildcats. He hit the ball a long way the last time, but hit it to one of the deepest areas of the park, deep center field. Caught about 5 feet from the wall by the center fielder. That was in the fourth inning and struck out in the first, so Chaney 0-for-2. Argenbright leads off first. Fair lead over there. And Peters. Pitch on the way. That bounced in, got off the catcher. Argenbright races to second. He'll make it in easily. That was a wild pitch. Bounced and hit the shoulder of the catcher and bounced away. So Argan Bride in scoring position now for the Wildcats with two out. And 1-0 the count to Jackson Cheney. Playing Cheney pretty well straight away. Maybe the center fielder a step or two over toward right. And Peters from the stretch. Here's the 1-0 pitch. It swung on and popped up on the infield. It's the shortstop trying to take charge and makes the catch. And the Wildcats pop a couple on the infield in the inning. And that's going to do it. A hit, but nothing more for the Wildcats. No runs, one hit. There were no errors by the Owls, and one Wildcat left on base. We've played 5.5 from Rockwall, and our score, Joshua 2 and the Wildcats 0. Payson Edwards now working his sixth inning. He's given Joshua two runs, those both unearned, and just one hit. As we play here in the bottom of the sixth inning, he'll be facing 2, 3, and 4, some of the best hitters Joshua has here in the bottom of the sixth. Start with Matt Haley. He's the first baseman and, again, a highly touted pitcher. We saw him on Thursday night and were able to beat him in that Wildcat 3-2 win. Payson Edwards, he's been tough today against the right-hander Matt Haley. And the pitch on the way is swung on and popped to Argan Bright at shortstop. And actually, yes, Argan Bright will take charge and makes the catch out there for out number one as Haley hits the first pitch he sees for out number one. That'll bring up Brick Galbraith. He has the one and only hit for Joshua. It was an RBI single in the fourth inning. He flied to rights in the first and then had the RBI single in that big two-run fourth. So he is a 1-2 against Payson Edwards. Edwards' first pitch on the way is swung on, one hopper. Oh, it went right through Colson Hale out into right center field. And the runner, a big turn at first, and he will hold on there. As that ball on this artificial turf will get to you in a big hurry. And so Galbraith is on at first with one out, and that'll bring up Blake Alexander. He's 0 for 2. He flied to left and hit into a double play. And now hitting with one on and one out here in the bottom of the sixth. Wildcats trying to get him out here and see if they can't rally in their last at bat in the top of the seventh inning. And the pitch from Edwards outside, ball one. Catcher Birchfield came up ready to throw in case that runner was thinking about stealing. Now Alexander back in the batter's box. Edwards from the stretch. And will turn and throw to first, and base runner Galbraith is back in there. And Payson Edwards looking in, trying to get that sign from the stretch. Fairly decent lead off of first, and the pitch is swung on and grounded. Sims flags it down, throw to second out there, and Sims had to go down to the ground to get that ball, but he did get the lead runner. No chance for the double play. The ball was just not struck hard enough. So a fielder's choice for Alexander. He's on at first, but the Wildcats do retire Galbraith from Sims throwing over to the second baseman, Colson Hale. So two outs now for Joshua. And here's Andrew Bell, grounded to second and walked. So he is officially 0 for 1. And now Edwards steps off, and that causes the base runner, Alexander, to head back to the bag. Bell, a right-handed hitter, with two outs and a runner at first. And the pitch from Edwards is swung on and hit deep to center field. It's going to be over Austin Dodd's head. This is going to chase in a run, I think. Dodd had a little bit of trouble picking it up, and the throw is bobbled out back into the infield. A triple for Andrew Bell. And drives in the third run for Joshua. That ball was with a best hit ball off of Payson all day long today. Dodd was, as fast as he is, racing after that ball. It was well over his head and one hopped the wall in right center field. So a 3-0 score now. And here's designated hitter Lane Snow with a runner at third and two outs. Snow 0-for-2, struck out, grounded to short. And Payson Edwards, a breaking ball, hit right into the screen right in front of me here for strike one. Good old screen. And Snow back in the batter's box, down in the count 0-1. But Blake Alexander showing why he's a cleanup hitter. Boy, he put a charge in that triple. And the 0-1 pitch. Swung on, hit foul off the right field line. Actually bounced and looked like it hit in the Wildcats bullpen. So 0-2 the count to Lane Snow. Joshua, 3-0 lead now. The mountain just got a little taller. And Edwards with the 0-2 pitch. That's up too high, and that's one ball and two strikes. That triple, only the second hit in the ball game for Joshua. And all of their runs have been unearned today. And anything else in this inning will be. And the 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss on a nice breaking ball by Payson Edwards. Boy, I tell you what, he deserves a better fate today. Been some untimely errors again for the Wildcats defense. That was a key to them playing such good defense to the winning streak. But, boy, it's hurt them the last couple of days. One run scores. One hit by Joshua. One error by the Wildcats. And one runner left on base. So we played six complete innings now from Rockwall. And a new score as the Wildcats get ready to come up for their top of the seventh inning. It's Joshua 3 and the Wildcats 0. Top of the seventh inning for the Wildcats. They've got to stir it up here or the season will be over for them. Cameron Harrison up. He has not had an official at bat. He walked and was hit by a pitch. And Peters first pitch and hit by Harrison. It's a rope down the right field line. It hops against the wall. And Harrison will cruise into second base with a leadoff double. Boy, Harrison got a good piece of that one and hit it where the right fielder couldn't catch up to it, and it one bounced the wall, and Harrison steams into second with a leadoff double for the Wildcats. That'll bring up Austin Dodd. He is 0-for-2, struck out in the second and the fifth. But as I say, with a good hitter, he's due. And here's Austin Dodd, with Harrison running at second. And Peters' pitch to Dodd is up too high in the strike zone for ball one. Maybe just a little bit even above the letters on that one to Dodd. Wildcats trying to have a big inning here. And the 1-0 pitch, that was low. And 2-0 the count to Austin Dodd. That hit off Peters was just the third that he's given up in the ball game. And the 2-0 pitch to Austin Dodd. That's in there for a call strike. 2-1 the count. Winner of this series, I'm fairly certain, will play. I believe it's Corsicana. I believe they beat Lindale in a one-game series. Well, not a series, a one game, one and done. And the 2-1 pitch swung on. Dodd got a foul tip on it, but held by the catcher. But that doesn't make a difference unless it's strike three. So it's 2-2. What was the rule that we had in Little League? They would say a foul ball has to be over the batter's head. Or maybe it was the catcher's head. I can't remember. But anyway, a foul tip, obviously not in that class. And the 2-2 pitch, there's a swing and a miss, and Dodd can't catch up to the pitch, and he strikes out for out number one here in the top of the seventh inning. Here's Jace Thompson. He's 0 for 2 in the ball game. He also struck out twice in the second and the fifth. Wildcats having a tough time making contact. Several of them are anyway against Peters, who has really thrown a masterful ball game today. From the stretch, looks back at Harrison, and the pitch to Thompson, swing and a miss. Yeah, Dodd and Thompson have had a hard time making contact on this big righty, who has just been raring back and throwing fastballs. Will Sims in the on-deck area for the Wildcats. Cameron Harrison led off the inning with a double. And the 0-1 pitch swung on by Jace Thompson and hit to right center field, and it's going to be between the fielders and all the way to the wall. Harrison racing around third. He will score, and Jace Thompson will hit a triple as he is all the way into third base, and the Wildcats will now bring the tying run to the plate as they have scored on a double and a triple here in the inning. Boy, a well-struck ball by Jace Thompson. The outfielders were running as hard as they could for Joshua, but they just could not get to it. This is a spacious ballpark, appears to be, out in the gaps, especially that right center gap. Looks way out there. And now a pitcher's meeting taking place as the tying run, Will Sims at the plate for the Wildcats. Now you see the importance of that big insurance run in the bottom of the sixth. Be a completely different ball game if we were talking 2-1 instead of 3-1. You'd have that tying run down at third base in the form of Jace Thompson. Just one out in the inning, and Will Sims has a hit in the ball game. He singled in the fifth after hitting a fly ball to center field for an out in the third, so one out of two. The meeting with the pitcher is over, and they'll stick with big Zach Peters. And Will Sims into the batter's box. Joshua deep all the way around for Sims as Thompson leads off third base. And here's Peter's first pitch. Swung on and hit foul down the third base way. Third baseman fielded and threw to first, but the third base umpire ruled that foul right away as the third baseman crossed over into foul territory to corral that ball. So one strike, the count to Will Sims. He'll return to home. Wildcats need a little bit more thunder and lightning here. They had a little bit with a double and a triple in the inning. An RBI triple for Jace Thompson, driving in Cameron Harrison, who had doubled. And the stretch. And the 0-1 pitch, ooh, swing and a miss. Ball bounced out in front of home plate. The catcher tracked it down, and Thompson staying at third base. So Sims down in the count now, 0-2. And Will back in the batter's box. I would expect Peters just to really let one loose here, big fastball. Let's see. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Oh, it looked like that might have been a breaker, but it was in there for a call strike. And once again, Peters racking up the strikeouts. Struck out two in this inning. So two out, the last hope for the Wildcats now. Their pitcher, Payson Edwards. He represents the tying run for the Wildcats in the ball game, as they have hit a couple of well-struck balls here in the top of the seventh inning. Now they're down to their last out, though, and Payson Edwards 0 for 2. And the pitch from Peters. Ooh, swing and a miss. Boy, Payson took a huge cut at it, trying to tie the ball game. Can't imagine the kind of blow it would take to get it out of this park today with this heavy air. It just doesn't seem to be. I mean, even those well-struck balls bouncing well short of the wall. Swing and a miss for Payson Edwards. The Wildcats now down to their last strike in the ballgame. Payson steps out to kind of contemplate the next pitch, get his mind right. Peters from the stretch. And the 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss, and that's going to do it. The Wildcat season ends as Joshua has come back from a loss in game one to win the last 2 days against the Wildcats, and they celebrate over around the third baseline. And the Wildcats will be left to ponder what might have been the saddest words. Well, I can't remember that expression, but it's what might have been. Those are sad words indeed. As the Wildcats do rally to score a run here, but they were down by three. They had one run on a couple of hits. Were no errors by the Owls. And one runner left on base. And our final score, Joshua 3 and the Wildcats 1. So the Wildcats' season record will end at 18-12. It had that wonderful 8-game winning streak when they were 10-10 at one point and 2-8 in district play. But the Wildcats managed to win 5 district games in a row to get into the playoffs with a 7-8 record. And then managed to beat arch rival Hallsville in 2 games last weekend in at Mike Carter Field in Tyler. But the Wildcats come up short today, and once again their defense kind of opened the door for the Owls and allowed them to score 3 unearned runs. So that just about tells you all you know. I'll tell you another thing. Payson Edwards deserved a better fate today as he pitched a wonderful ball game. He really was tough, just allowing a few hits. I think he only allowed 2 in the ball game. But 3 Wildcat errors are more than he could overcome as he pitched well. But again, deserved a better fate. Had a really good game pitching today, but not good enough. So James Terry running spots back at the station. Doug Haston did all of our engineering work today, and also shooting video on the replay that will be coming your way on Channel 18 on Suddenlink Cable. At some point, if Joshua is knocked out of the playoffs, we might see the game on YouTube, but it'll take a while. We'll have to see how long Joshua lasts after this series as they move along to the regional quarterfinal. I'm Don Julian with your play-by-play. Once again, our final score, game 3 of this best 2 out of 3 area series. The Joshua Owls 3 and the Wildcats of Sulphur Springs 1. Thank you for listening on this Saturday afternoon, and so long, everybody.
Thank you, Don. You've been listening to Wildcat Baseball on KSST 1230 AM, Sulphur Springs, Texas. Back to good time oldies after this message from UIL.